Hey everybody, this is Bud Brown. I'm going to do a real quick video in response to a comment that I got. So I'll make my own response and then I'll read the comment to you. But anyway, I was inspired to make this video in response to this comment because I wanted to let you know that all your life, now I know a lot of my audience is older men like myself, but I know there's a lot of young men and a lot of young Filipinos and ladies and men that are also on my subscribers to my channel. So this is to everybody, and probably the older fellas know this already. But all your life, you're going to get people that want to tear you down, put you down, tell you can't do it, you're doing a bad job. But I'm here to tell you, who cares? There's been a few times in my life where I say to myself, whose life am I living anyway? My life or their life? So I'll read this comment to you and then we'll take it from there. Do you know what? I'm actually tired of hearing foreigners say, hey, I'm fluent in speaking this language or this language because I go online every day and study languages. No, sorry, bud. That is not how you learn languages. So I've got my ears wide open because I want to know, how do you learn languages? He said, you are not fluent in any language aside from speaking the English language. I've heard you talk Cebuano, and I've already given you a fail on that one. I've heard you try your best in Tagalog, but again, another fail. What I'm trying to say is that you may know bits and pieces of a particular language, but it does not mean that you are 100% fluent in speaking them. I speak three languages, Tagalog, Ilonggo, and English. I can honestly say that I am 100% fluent in those languages or dialect. I guess he doesn't know the difference between language or dialect. Anyway, growing up in the Philippines and speaking the language helps a lot. So, this young fellow's he's a Philam. That means he's half American and half Filipino. And evidently he was born and raised in the Philippines, but he's living in Glendale, California right now. But I kind of thought that something was a little bit strange with this fellow when I had a beautiful video about a family, a Filipino family, that got together and made a big spaghetti feast. And we went down to this barangay, and the barangay captain, she brought all these young children together and we fed them spaghetti. And after all the beautiful video and the caring and the love and the warmth of the video, this young man's response was, no drinks? So you can see he may be Americanized even though he was born and raised here in the Philippines. But he talks about he's tired of us foreigners saying that we're 100% fluent in certain languages. So I'm not sure if he saw the same videos that I put up, but I can't remember one time where I said I was 100% fluent in any language. I mean, there's some language that I do feel comfortable speaking. I feel comfortable speaking in Tagalog, although he gave me an F. Do I care? And I feel comfortable speaking in Spanish. I feel comfortable speaking in Vietnamese. But in language learning, there's different levels of fluency. And most people that are studying languages and are learning languages, especially myself, I only spoke English until I was 17. And then I spent a little time, a summer with a Mexican family. That's kind of gotten me started in Spanish. And then I went back to the university and got a BA in linguistics, which is the study of languages. So I've studied a lot of languages. But I never would say that I'm 100% fluent in anything besides English. But the point is, in learning a language, is the communication. And if you followed my videos, you know, I get a real hoot out of talking with native speakers. And I know I probably have a very strong, maybe American accent, or I have the perfect grammar, but who cares, you know? And that's what I want to encourage you. Not necessarily language learning, but anything that you want to do. Some are considering coming here to the Philippines. Of course, you do your due diligence, you study, you research, and then just go for it. One time, Gloria and I don't know if you know, but we had a big Go-Wing, Honda Go-Wing, and I wanted to go across the United States. Oh, don't go, it's too dangerous, da-da-da, and this and that. We went anyway, and man, it was one of the greatest memories that we have together. She was on the back and helmet and talking with her microphone, and she's sitting back there like, you know, if you know a Honda Go-Wing, it's just a great, big, comfortable bike. And so, and then I've had people say, no, don't get, you have to get a car here in the Philippines, because it's not a matter of if you get in an accident, but when you get in an accident. And I'll just say that I've been here 4 years. I've never even been close to an accident, although maybe it'll happen, but my fear is not going to keep me from trying to do what I want to do. That's the same with languages. So I don't want to carry on too long about this. This fellow says that he speaks three languages fluently, and I'm proud of him for that. I just want to say, I don't know if he's trying to compare himself with me or not, but I'll just say, yeah, you're the winner. You're the winner.
Well, okay, I quit. I lose. You're the winner.
You can speak three languages fluently and I can't. So good luck, goodbye, and I'm sorry that I blocked you, but I had to, because I just don't like naysayers and people that are negative to be subscribing and putting out bad vibes on my channel. So anyway, everybody, I just hope that you maybe get some encouragement out of this. Like I said, there's going to be people trying to put you down and say you're not good enough and this and that. Who cares? You're the captain of your own ship, as Shakespeare would say. And I wish you the best. Everybody, take care. And I'll keep you up to date on what's going on with, you know, John and any other things that are going on in my life. I appreciate you subscribing and watching my videos. And I know it takes time to make a comment, because it's easy to watch videos, and myself included, watch videos and just, yeah, you like it, you enjoy it, and then just move on. But it does help the YouTube channel if you were to make a little comment about it, and because YouTube has an algorithm that one of them is audience participation. I try to answer as many comments as I get. I can't always, but I try my best to. So if you can make a comment or thumbs up or whatever you want to do is fine. All right, talk to you later. Bye-bye.
Pag-alag na sa ngayon, ngayon. Sabi ko, honey, paano ka? Kalimutan yung salita. Unang salita mo.
Oo.
Sabi niya, ma, nakakintindi ako, pero hindi na.
Hola amigos, este es mi amigo. Está de California, pero sus padres son de México, ¿verdad?
Sí, todos son de México.
Entonces,
yo soy pocho.
Vivo en las Filipinas y vengo para acá para visitar a mi mamá cada Pascua.
¿Usted vive en las Filipinas?
Sí, sí.
Está muy lejos.
Pero me gusta muchísimo.
¿Sí? ¿Y cómo aprendió español?
¿Yo?
¿Sí?
Cuando yo era joven, yo vivía con una familia mexicana en México, Guadalajara. Oh, yeah. Desde allá, pero yo soy puro gabachito. No, es que también, después de pensionarme, mi esposa y yo fuimos a México para vivir con dos años en Guanajuato.
¿En qué parte?
A San Miguel de Allende, Guanajuato.
Oh, Guanajuato.
Pero no entiende nada.
¿Ya vi?
Cháu ở bên đây 1978.
Đây, nó quá sự quá hơn cả. Thầy không nói tiếng Việt, thế thì không có lẽ.
Ở Việt Nam bao nhiêu lâu?
Một năm
rồi. Một năm? Từ ngàn bị 71. 71 tới bao nhiêu năm? Tới mấy năm?
Cho 71 đến 32.
Một năm.
Một năm rồi.
Mà biết nói tiếng Việt.
Mà trước khi trở đến đó, thầy học tiếng Việt.
À, học tiếng Việt.
Xin chào. Thầy biết nói tiếng Việt một ít thôi. Mà ông ở đây hả?
Ừ, ở đây.
Đây là lần
làng Việt Nam. Trường,
hả?
Làng Việt Nam.
À, tôi nó à thì tôi người lính, tôi ở nước Việt Nam. Ồ, phải có thể nói tiếng Việt bà bây giờ. Nó khó rồi thật đấy.
Bà là người Mỹ.
À, tôi ở Đà Nẵng. Năm 1971
chiến tranh Việt Nam. Bạn
tôi không thích nói chiến tranh. Đi tham là tham thôi. Đi tham.